A note on departures. This is a lovely, wonderful Japanese film, and in fact, I'm thinking that I have not seen a Japanese film that I don't like. It's true that they're not on TV or the cinema every week. They tend to be rare, but I was noting recently in the past few months, again, maybe there's a film once every 2 or 3 months, the Japanese film on HBO Cinemax. On The Eel, very interesting, strange story of a man who comes out of jail with an eel, with a fish as a pet. Comes with it in a bag, and keeps it in an aquarium, but strange to have that, and strange things happen to him. Then there is the, I forgot the title, the paste made of beans. There's also a man as a hero who is working in a something like the Japanese equivalent maybe of a fast food joint, only they don't serve hamburgers, very good. They serve specialties, and he makes something of beans. Red bean, lovely. He takes as a helper and becomes friendly with an older woman. This one has won the Best Foreign Film Oscar, the Academy Award for Best Film in a Foreign Language in 2009. And Masahiro Motoki is Daigo Kobayashi, the hero. He's a cellist without a job. Come to think of it, heroes have issues and problems. At least the three films I mentioned, I've seen the past few months. He goes to his old hometown because the orchestra is dissolved, it's not functioning anymore, and he's looking for ads, and he finds one called Departures, name of the film. Okay, he thinks this is in the travel business, only it's an advertisement for Nokanchi, the man who prepares the body for the tomb. So the departures, in fact, are the departures from this world. And this is an invitation to meditate on life and death. It's funny at times, even if people around him, wife, friends, consider this, if not disgusting, an embarrassing, anyway, an embarrassing job. And it... I we know you get used with anything, almost anything. Hedonic adaptation, it's called the phenomenon positive psychology. But we still don't adapt to certain things like unemployment, the departure of a loved one. But otherwise, with sound, loud sound, if you're thinking of moving near an airport, think again. So I guess people get used to that, even if it's facing death every day. That could help. I was reminded of Dostoevsky in his last 3 minutes. Dostoevsky was sentenced to death, and in front of the execution squad, he had 3 minutes, and he divided them into three, obviously. 1 minute to say goodbye to friends, family, another to think of his life, pass it in front of him, the highlights, so to say, and the last to admire a ray of sunshine which was falling on top of a church nearby. He is pardoned at the last moment, or, as I've read somewhere, that this might have been just meant to frighten him a little. Maybe they didn't have the idea to kill him anyway to begin with, but he didn't know it. And he says, life is extraordinary when faced with departure. One understands that he would rather be on an island, on a rock, in fact, bare rock in the middle of the ocean, than die. And we have this in Crime and Punishment, I guess, the Demons, the Karamazov brothers. There are characters who talk about this. Last moment. The Japanese are special. They have a meaning to live. Ikigai, it is called. And it, psychology and other studies have discovered that one reason, there are a few important reasons. One reason why people live to such an old age in such big numbers in Okinawa is Ikigai, this Ikigai. They never retire. They don't have retirement in the language. So they're active. And another, of course, is the Japanese diet, which makes departures happen at an old age.